Good afternoon, friends. This is Abdul Kapoor, and welcome back to the Teaching Lab. This is a pedagogical course for early child development. Firstly, thank you so much for your queries and questions. I'm trying my best to satisfy your needs. I know that everybody or every subject specialist rushes to find out the useful resources from somewhere. And my approach is to give you the useful resources to everyone, including math, early child development, cycle one, cycle two, the friends. So, my most of the time is for my viewers, my subscribers, and I'm trying my best. I'm still learning and giving certain. So please, whenever I'm uploading the video or whenever I'm sharing the content, you have to go through the whole video. Don't skip, you know, these steps, okay? Because sometimes what happens, you are looking for only the answering questions. That's not a logical. It will definitely give you a tough time in your test. So I'm advising to you to watch the video, a complete video, and follow the information, follow the instructions. So why I'm asking to you? Because our questions have been judged from the concepts and the theories and the information. If you're going to miss these things and you are just focusing on the questions, I think that is not useful. So that's my personal advice to you. And you have to. So after many requests and queries to upload the early child development MCQs questions, as I have mentioned in my previous video, that there are a lot of the theories which have been already uploaded into the cycle one. So today I'm going to share more links which I have uploaded and the new links as well as in the description. So you have to go through it. Second thing, if you want more videos like that and if you have anything you want to, from me, I can prepare a lesson for you. No problem. Just write in the comment box. Okay. If it's a little bit late, I don't think that I don't read your messages or something. I'm going through all your messages, all these things. So today, this is on a high demand of this lesson to upload the early child development, a sample questions of different. So these sample questions are really important and you can check it out through viewers. I'm giving you further description. Links into the description. You have to go through to read the information from the links and website, and then prepare your own notes as well. I think so. In this video, what I'm going to do, I'm focusing on the standard one performance criteria one. If you're gonna want to check this criteria, you have to go through the pedagogy test guide. Okay, and how to extract from the scratch. Okay, how to create the multiple choices from there. How do you know what type of the multiple choice you can expect from? So these are not simple. It has been already covered in the previous test of cycle one. So you can check this information, watch this video, complete video, and then don't forget to subscribe. It's a humble request. If you have any question, please. So let's see what I'm going to cover in this one. I'm going to share the screen. You have to check this one. This is about the early child development, as you can see on the screen, standard one, performance criteria one. First, you should know that what you are going to study and streamline your course, okay? So in this playlist, I'll be streamline your course and give you all the performance indicator and according to you know, my information, my knowledge, and if not, I will be providing you link as well. So you can see here what exactly the standard one says, and these are the performance standards. It's about the child development. So first standard is about the child development, and this is the performance criteria one of the standard one. Demonstrate understand of child development theories and children's development character. So in this performance criteria, there are the two perspective aspects we're going to discuss. One is the development theories, another one is the characteristic. So I have mentioned one of the theory in this lesson, and an upcoming lesson I'll be keep adding, you know, that's it. But I will give you the overview of all these theories. Now, this standard is covering on three domains or the performance indicators: demonstrated understanding of physical, social, emotional, and cognitive development milestone. I'll tell you about what is a milestone meaning in the early child development. This is a very important thing you should know, which demonstrate understand of children's development characteristics from the birth to 8 years. I'll be telling you what are the main characteristics of each stage and how the characteristics have been changed with the age development or the stage development. I'll be providing you a link for the main stages of the development. You have to go through it, and that is from newborn. So mainly there are the five stages of the development, but I will give you the link to age wise you have to go through. Demonstrate understanding of the development theories in early childhood. So as I mentioned, I'll focus on the one theory, which is the behavioral theory of the Skinners and the other systems. So you have to wait for them. So these are the performance indicators and criteria you have to study on. So it's very simple. It's very simple. You have to understand and streamline and break out this information into parts in order to understand. You don't have to memorize each and everything. Okay. So let's go for the first thing. What are these theories? So they are the major child development theories. You can see there are the seven major child development theories. One, number one, you can see here, I'll take it from here. Psychosexual development, cognitive development, social learning theory, and psychosocial development, socio-cultural theory, behavioral child development, and attachment theory. So these are the most and major important theories you have to go through it. We'll not go for the in detail for the psychosocial development, okay? I will go for the rest of this one. So in this lesson, I'm going to talk about the behavioral child development theory. So there are the seven major development theories, okay? So which are related with the emotional brain activities, the social interaction, and how these theories are helping to understand the psyche of the children's, understanding the psyche of each and every stage. And what are the important things of the learners and what are the important things of the instructors has to do, and how these both have the collaborations, and what is the role of the environment and atmosphere in the development of the children. So let's see. Now, why we call these theories child development theory? Actually, child development theory focus on explaining how children change. Change means from one stage to another stage. So if you're going to check the child development from as a newborn baby to 3 months, 6 months, 8 months, 12 months, preschool and school age till 14 years age, that's the most important thing. Okay, so these theories, each theory is explaining individually the impact and the interaction and the different reaction and the different characteristics of the children. And these theories are explaining, and it has been proved by the different psychologists. Such theories center on various aspects of the development, including what? Social, emotional, and cognitive growth. Social, some students are more interactive. They like social interaction. Some they are sensitive, and some they are high learner. So the cognitive brain activities we categorize into the low, middle, and the high learner. So these are in the domain of the cognitive growth. So suppose, you know, if you have a question like that, okay, that these theories have been categorized into two. One is grand theories and mini theories. So if you're going to face a question of these theories, then the type of the questions will be like that. Which of the following theory best describe the every aspect of life? So the child development theories, some theories, they are covering each and every domain of the children development side. That is called the grand theory. So the answer will be grand theories. So you have to check it out. Grand theories are those theories which are covering every aspect of the child's development life, right? Second, which of the following theories best describe the limited aspects of the child development? So many theories, they are covering or limited characteristics of the child development, not all, you know. So it may be cognitive or maybe emotional or maybe social interaction of that one, but not all characteristics can be described in this mini theory. So the grand theories are covering the all aspects of the life. However, mini theories are limited aspects of the life. Now here I'm giving you the Erikson's psychological development theory. As I mentioned, I'll be covering the few. Okay, so one is the psychological development, which has been given by Erikson. What he said, that theory of psychological development describes the growth and change throughout the life. Now, throughout the life means from the birth till the end of the life. Okay, so what are the changes? Okay, and how psychologically impaired, your thoughts, your interaction, your emotions keep changing even. So there are the several stages of the life, okay? So Erickson describes that psychological development or social development theory. So if you're childhood, you like games, you love playing with the children, so you love, but when you grow up, okay, go to the school, you don't like these things. When you in the professional life, your psychosocialism, so your interactions, domains has been changed as well. So every stage of life, okay, according to this psychological development has been changed or focusing on different, depends on the stage of the life. So there are the different stages and your psychological approaches are the different and they have a conflict to each other. So our mentality as a young, you know, and adult, you know, we have a different interaction, way of the interaction as compared to their child, okay. So this is one of the example. Then other theory is a behavior child development theories. According to the behavior perspective, all human behaviors can be described in terms of environment influence. Definitely, I agree. Environment is forcing us to change our behavior interactions, okay. Even you can say that the weather, change in climate and all these things, interactions, conflict, okay, noisy, all these things, they are impacting on our lives, okay. So it depends on my personality that how I'm behaving and interacting upon it. So John B. Watson and B.F. Skinner's theory, I will be sharing the Skinner's theories link into the description part. You have to go through. This is very interesting, okay. He has been proved, okay, through experiment. Instead that the learning occurs purely through the process of association and reinforcement. So if you're going to reinforce somebody, if you're going to reinforce, definitely there will be changes. Either it will be positive, either it will be positive. So it depends on your positive reinforcement or the negative reinforcement. Sometimes the negative reinforcement has impact the positive changes on this one. So behavioral theories of child development focus on how environmental interaction influences behavior and is based on the theories and theories such as John B. Watson and Ivan Pavlov and B. Skinner. These theories deal only the observable behaviors. Development is considered a reaction to rewards, punishment, stimuli, and reinforcement. So these things have been highlighted by the aforementioned psychologist and all these things that how punishment, stimuli, reinforcement change the interaction or enforcing the development of the child. So these are the most important things you have to know. So which of the following, multiple choice for this one, one of the following method best describe the operant conditioning. Operant conditioning is the instrumental conditioning. As I have mentioned that conditioning theory has been given by Skinner. As I have mentioned in the previous, okay, that B.F. Skinner, he has given the operant condition, which is the instrumental conditions. What he said a method of learning that employs rewards and punishment for the behavior. So if you are rewarding somebody, definitely this action will be repeated. If you are punishing somebody, definitely the action will be discontinued. So he called the operant condition and he proved through an experiment of pigeon. I'll be sharing you the link into the description. So this is the multiple choice you can expect from the examiner. And these are the 3 or 4 options. A method of learning that employs reward and punishment for behavior. A learning process that occurs through the association between an environmental stimuli and natural occurring stimuli and process focusing on social interaction. So the first option is correct, that reinforcement and reward and punishment repeats and stops the action. That's truly another thing which is about the classical conditioning, okay, that which one of the following describe the classical condition is the learning process that occurs, I'm reading B, through the association between an environmental stimuli and naturally occurring stimuli. I'll be sharing the description form that you have can go for the classical condition. Classic condition is a learning process and an association between environment and natural, okay. So these both having the connection and associations to each other. Okay, so you have to go through it. I'll be sharing the description form. Now the characteristics of the, as I have mentioned, the one of the performance indicator criteria, the characteristic. These are the 4 domains of the characteristics, right? Number one, the communication and the speech domain, the physical domain, social and emotional domain, and the cognitive domain. So the stages of the early child development or adult, even depends on these four developments. So our characteristics depends on these ones, how the way we communicate, our physical appearance, interaction with the others, and our brain activities. These are the characteristics which are identifying early child development, and it gives you the what we call a domain of that one for identification and the personal features to be different in the group. Okay. Another one is the which one of the following best describe the milestone. As I mentioned, the milestone in the early child development. Milestone here is the means that the characteristics of the stage. So every stage has a different milestone. So don't be confused, okay, that if examiner asks you the milestone, that means the characteristics of a stage. So these are the things which I found the most important according to the performance criteria one and standard one. Standard one is continue. Stay with me, okay? If you want more videos like that, press the bell icon button. If you didn't subscribe yet, the teaching and learning, it's humble request to you. If you have any question, feel free, write email, anything the way you want to communicate me. Stay with me. We'll be meeting in the next lesson with a new topic, with a new theme. Thank you so much. Take care of your beloved. Take care of your children. Take care of your family. And make sure that you are following all the COVID precautions. Thank you. Stay blessed and stay safe.